Hello and welcome to another, not a replay cast. No, it's gonna be a live session. It's quite a while ago when I last did that, but I thought it was well received and people like to see what I'm doing when I'm actually in battle and, as much as I can commentate on what I'm thinking and what I'm doing. Because that shows you a bit kind of the learning process or the adaption process that is going on during the actual battle, in my opinion. I handled it the way that I played one cruiser game, one destroyer game, one battleship game. As you might have clearly seen, that's not my AU account because there are not really many ships around here. No, that's my NA account, so don't wonder. I will reduce it here though to two games, I think, and probably both will be cruisers since I have a lot of cruisers here to grind. And yeah, maybe I put in the Normandy. Jutland is a pretty easy ship to play, so in my opinion at least, because it's super strong for its tier. Maybe not necessarily needed. On the other hand, well, why not? We are doing three games. So you see, I have not really high commanders here. They have, like, this Fiji captain has only 5 points so far. But you can always work around that. And adjusting to this is always a good thing if you want to improve your own gameplay. So I just start with Fiji. So just as a remark, I don't have concealment expert, so get used to the new value, 11.2. So this is not really good for Fiji, right? Because Fiji loves to be aggressive, support the DDs and so on. But you can play around it. So we start with the Fiji then. And as I said, it could be a mediocre, maybe even bad game, or an outstanding game. That always depends. I can't say that, but I try obviously to win the game and do my best to help my team winning, right? And this is the whole purpose. How do I play random battles, and not only the like super cool ones where I have like 200-300k damage or something like that? No, it's just the ones that everybody of you plays with different success, I would say. One thing I should maybe remark is on NA you will find you have carrier games all the time. So it tends to be a bit more passive every now and then just because of this early spotting, and that's not so easy. All right. Yeah, I think it's... Is it that early in the morning? It should be early in the morning in, on NA. So, obviously the games you get takes a while. But yeah, we will get a game for sure. Fitchy, by the way, who doesn't have it, played it, it's an absolute great ship on tier 7. Unless you get thrown into tier 9, then you have really a kind of problems. There are other cruisers, like for example the Algerie, which are kind of in general the kiting cruisers who are doing really well against tier 9s. Fiji is not one of them, I would say. Doesn't punch up that that good against Tier 9 at least. Tier 8 is fine, but tier 9 is a problem sometimes. At least I find it. Alright, lucky we end up as top tier and we are playing on New Dawn. Oh, didn't play that map for ages. Okay, I said it before, I like to be aggressive and like to support my destroyers as good as I can. Enemy has 5 battleships, so this is definitely a thing you need to watch out for. But 4 destroyers. So this can already make a huge impact if you can maybe manage to kill 1 or 2 destroyers and don't lose too many in return. simply because then we have an edge in terms of spotting and, yeah, torpedo capabilities. Obviously, my spotting range is garbage. I think usually it would be 9.7, 9.9 after the concealment change a while ago. I think I can remember it was 9.7, but then the concealment value for cruisers changed. But yeah. Okay, I try not to get spotted, to have some kind of surprise effect, so I will use this island here, this one. And then maybe peek out. Also, important to notice, what is my smoke firing penalty? So it's 5.4 kilometers. Keep that in mind, so don't smoke up too close. And I don't wanna like go out here smoke full broadside. No, no. I will turn in and then move in the smoke if I see it there. A bit unfortunate that the Gede isn't going in with so much support, but okay. Of course, there are battleships often enough here. Looks as if no destroyer is there yet. Okay, Leningrad is at A. Okay, Anshan down there. It looks as if the enemy has no interest in B so far. Then I think, yeah, one destroyer is missing, which is the Acasta. Wherever he is. Okay, my plan is now to help out at A. And hopefully don't get spotted. And when saying this, this is exactly happening, so I have to turn away. Priority target counter shows 2. What is this, an IFHE? Omaha? Looks like it, because otherwise I don't think my engine would break. There must be a destroyer here in this vicinity, I think. Or the landing card spotted me. So this is like the danger of playing with without a concealment expert. But everybody who's starting to grind the line has to deal with it. Means naturally you have to stay a bit further away and can't play as aggressive as you would like to. But yeah, always very important is this area of the map from this side, in my opinion. Getting control over A and A and B is good. This is always a lost cause because I don't like the approach from this side. And yeah, you see it here already. My team stays longer. The Colorado should have turned. Nelson is sitting there and is like, getting farmed. The Furutaka is dead, as expected. And yeah. 11 kilometers on a Leningrad is, well, he's reversing though. Okay, I take some pot shots. Obviously, I try to have a look out on the battleships because that's the targets you usually get nailed off. Okay, so that helped already. Julius Cesaro dies in there. That was so obvious that will happen. You can't move around in the middle of the map that early. That's just not gonna work. Problem here is already that the battleships are fleeing. But since I have a lot of spotting here because of my destroyers, my plan is... okay. I think I will handle this Omaha now. All stations requesting fire support. It's reversing. Yeah, nice aim there. always reducing and accelerating my speed. And I mean, I'm getting aim for at from something, but I don't know what it is. So it could be from the south. These guys have broadside on me. And I keep my... I think I should use... I wish I would know who's aiming at me, but I don't know. Maybe the Lyon, maybe the Colorado, I have no clue. No point shooting them angled again. So destroyers coming close. Oh. Ah, lucky. And I will use this island. Obviously I'm not running into there. I'm still here to support my destroyer. And I'm getting spotted. This sucks obviously. But not anymore. So he's like there-ish. Just spotting me outside. Everything is angled. This is a bit unfortunate for me. Is he moving now? No clue where their destroyer is, honestly. I have literally no clue. One destroyer was not spotted a single time. Okay, I'm now feeling a bit more confident. To go a bit closer. Because this whole crossfire is... Still the destroyer is spotting me, I have no clue where he is. Slowing down already and having a look on these guys, not that any one of them is... Ah. Okay, then we know where the destroyer is. This is the Acasta, okay. Double citadel, that's nice. And now I have a lot of broadsides. And that's obviously what we want to have. Let's see, destroyer. Get one or two salvos out, I think. Not enough fleet. Oh, this one should be good. Yeah, and if you sit in smoke, don't forget to use your hydro. Victory is in sight. Torpedoes to port. Yeah, and this is the one game, I think. Not so much damage. Usually you want to kill the destroyers, that gives you usually a pretty good XP value. Oh yeah, you also saw that I only used my smoke once this game. So people would one of the biggest mistakes the people are doing is using the smoke too often and too early. You want to go in a good position to use it. And now I can play around freely. Just go for that Suri. He brought himself exactly in the same bad spot as the Miyoko, going in front of that island where he has no chance to evade instead of turning in, which is obviously not great. And he's paying the price. Yeah, sadly couldn't finish him off. Yep, someone else is doing it, but the majority of damage I did on him, so that's good. Yeah, I would say that was not a high damage game, but in terms of effectiveness, okay. Took enough precautions to not get wiped out. Is he turning? I don't want to shoot yet. I want to turn, make him turn, or what is he doing? Okay, I'm shooting then. Okay, don't get exactly what his plan is, if he has a plan. Me and my luck. Ah, well. I'll take it. Was not a close game, my team did overall really well, and that's usually where you don't get too much, but a second... Wow, the Nelson took out, so he holds his ground there for quite a long. Probably gave us a lot of time and also killed two ships, so don't mind that. But usually, as I said, the seaside from the area we started on this map is not really great for our side. At least I see that teams are usually losing there, because the enemy somehow always goes there with a big fleet. Yeah, second in XP. Don't want to complain. That's okay. Absolutely. Alright, so that's the Fiji. I go ahead with another cruiser, I think. I don't feel like playing battleship right now. A challenging one, in my opinion, is Baltimore. It's a good ship, but it lacks things, especially against tier 10. You can get a bloody nose pretty quickly if you don't pay attention and watch out. Oh. And I just figured that I have enough XP to get me the the upgraded hull. That would explain some things. I totally forgot that. Well, that reduces my credits to about zero again. Ouch. But I can sell the A hull. And that's it, right? I don't have much more, no. Oh, okay, this one as well. And the rest I can't sell. Well, okay, so then we have the B-Hull now. Totally forgot about this. Gives you obviously a bit more survivability and is strongly recommended, but I went for range first because Baltimore has a really limited range, and if you end up against tier 10, then your only option is to sit behind islands. You usually do this anyways because I find Baltimore extremely bad at kiting, even with rudder shift modules, so I went for acceleration to be able to run around close to islands pretty quickly. Same like with Des Moines. But Des Moines does have the legendary module, therefore, yeah, it's a bit easier for Des Moines to do exactly that. But yeah, let's see if you get a game in. Maybe some of you asked themselves, what is it about the DD guide that I plan to do? Well, I have no time and I'm working on it. So expect it in at least one episode where I go over the basics and so on. Next week, I think I will be able. I'm still collecting replays. Obviously, always these patches like annoy me because sometimes I can't use the replays anymore and so on. And then my collection died more or less, but I collected over the time. And under normal circumstances, if I would work like regularly and not be in home office like I am now right now, I would have had a hard time to finish it, because it's hard to find one single replay where everything is covered what you need to know in terms of basics, right? But yeah, expect it around next week. I put probably all my effort in it right now, or most of my effort. That's also why I'm a bit lazy and bringing up this live session, but I think that live session also helps you out, so. Okay, we got a game with a carrier, who would have guessed. Good map though, I like that map. Okay, tier 8, tier 6, also pretty lucky. Obviously you have radar, concealment 9.9, so this is a way more progressed captain. I have, I think, 16 points so far, so obviously I have a concealment expert. Initially going aggressive, trying to help out with radar. This is my first plan. Since this is a carrier game with Saipan, for example, this is gonna be a bit more tricky. You have some options. You either go here, but then you have only shots on this area. If I go here and peek out, my intention is just to peek out in case I radar, and just as soon as the radar is gone, I hide behind the island, because I don't want to sustain like long range fire from of like Atagos and so on from all these cruisers or from battleships, because then you drop pretty quickly. So don't have your focus on continuous fire in the start. You can shine in the late game. Okay, obviously I'm not spotted here, so I can definitely get some pot shots out, but yeah, my intention is basically stay safe first. What the heck? And obviously, also a feature of these heavy and light cruisers of the US Navy, they can lob shells over islands pretty effective. Okay, that looks like as if they would abandon it here completely. Cap isn't blocked yet. I have full radar coverage if necessary. Okay, I don't know what this Prince Eugen is doing though. Yeah, we're still capping. Okay, good. So no necessity for me to go. But then you have time to look at the minimap. And you see that North Carolina is going south. Bayern is coming in, and the Prince Eugen is coming in. Okay, I'm loading AP for the Prince Eugen. Since the Baltimore has a 27 mm bow, you are able to bounce 380 mm guns. That means, in this regard, I don't have to be feared at all of the Bayern down there. Absolutely not. The only thing that concerns me is... North Carolina. So as long as he can't shoot me. What is this? I hate shooting behind islands. It's so... I have literally no clue how it's done. Finally, that's the third salvo. Yeah, no point. Super strange stuff. Okay, we have a large force here, to put it mildly. And the enemy is running, so I don't like to chase Especially not around this area if I'm not in a battleship or a flanking cruiser that can go here. And I don't have the range for that. And this is like underwhelming volleys. My intention is not to push, as I said. Let the battleship do that. Seems as if there is no DD here. I'll try to farm whatever is necessary from here. That was the Harald Kase, was short, briefly spotted down here. I think I'm giving it a go. Can't make it behind the island or what? Ah, that's some damage. Not much, but it's some. And he has the carrier was like quick in his reaction. It costs him quite a lot of HP. That's good. I like that. So near from this position, I'm fairly safe. I can even farm. Messer up there. This is good. I'm going a bit behind. Because my crew isn't allowing them to push here, so I can't be spotted unless the carrier is coming close. And yeah. Therefore, I can happily farm now. This is good. Concentrate fire on the enemy warship. Harald Kase, pretty close. I mean, we lost the other side. I have to watch out for this here, for sure. But if we can kill ships here quickly enough, then this is a good thing. I mean, Baltimore is not known to be a super good HE spammer, but it will do its work. Huh. Still unspotted. So I think I found here somewhat of a sweet spot, I have to admit. And obviously don't forget after you farm, or while you're farming, to watch the minimap. You need to check how it's going, what's going on the rest of the map, if you have to react and so on. So that's a mistake a lot of people do if they are sitting in such positions where they can't be spotted and so on. But you have to react as soon as something changes. If these guys push up here, it's a Bayern, Leander, Otago, that's a thing I would go aggressive for if necessary, right? Because that Queen Elizabeth, yeah, is already under heavy pressure. Okay, I try to help out and killing this NC first. Because that gives us big advantage, and then I will go and counter this. These are, yeah, I have radar, so my concealment is pretty good, and the Bayern can't overmatch me. The only concern could become the carrier, I would say. So I have to see how I do it. Attention. Support that target. The Dallas should go here-ish. Well, okay. Or at least kite in the this area. But it looks as if these guys are handling it down here, hopefully. Oh, Otago up. I'm loading AP. Maybe he's doing some dumb shit, like getting rid of torpedoes or so. We've all seen that. Don't expect to get good hits, but okay. Well, that's not too shabby. I had worse. Success. Good game. Well, usually I wouldn't say that. I mean, it looks pretty good because this team pushed through really, really quickly. I mean, I don't have the highest damage numbers. Well, that's how it is sometimes. But now is the time to rack it up. The question is, where did... Ah, there's the Bayon. So I can easily take him on. And I will stay here. Slow down. Angle. Reverse. Yeah, that's the Leander behind him. They can't do much against me at that angle. Concentrate fire on the enemy warship. And you have also improved pen angles, but the Bayon is pretty much angled as well, so. I'm really getting unlucky with my volleys. This is a shame. Leander is angled. Wow. Bayon armor is no joke. It's honestly no joke. Okay, there we got a fire. And now I will fire on that Leander. Okay, still only two people, so that's both of them here. And I wasn't surprised that Leander, I think he will have turned broadside in the smoke probably. Yep. Just to get rid of his torpedoes, pretty sure. But somehow I'm not really lucky with my volleys, I don't know. Ah, finally. Ah, and the new pen angles proved to be perfect. Shooting the superstructure now since he's angled too much, but yeah. And two tier 6 ships. Actually, they didn't play it bad. The Bayon realized at some point, okay, I can't pen him, so he shot my gun. He should have switched to HE in my opinion, but that's a different story. Leander, yeah, well, he can't do much. What he should have done is probably go into my flank if the possibility is there. If not, well, then it's problematic, right? Okay. Targo is always a good thing for this AP. Couldn't finish off, sadly. Yeah, only the Saipan and Bayon alive. I think in the end, decent amount of damage. And that's how you optimally play it. If they rush you both, then you have to reverse to don't give them any angle on you. I mean, I lost half HP. I actually don't know how. Probably just superstructure shots or so. At some point, they probably realized that. And yeah, but you can tank quite a lot if you want to. Especially like lower tier battleships that don't have 406mm or plus caliber. Oh. Hello.
Wait. No.
Oh. There's some extra damage. Maybe the Atago dies, but I think the Bayon dies before, and yeah. Don't think we will get any good damage anymore on the carrier. Unfortunate, but okay. It is how it is. Also got pretty lucky with the matchmaking, to be honest. Two times top tier is obviously, yeah, very, yeah, how can I say it? Not easy, but usually an easier go than the other way around. Against tier 10, whew, you can have rough games for sure. Alright, second in base XP, this is probably the Bismarck that rushed through. Yeah, the only criticism I have about the Baltimore, it feels as if it needs a little bit better DPM. That's all. The rest of the ship is absolutely totally fine. But I guess since Wargaming is thinking that it's totally fine, well, we won't see this. Alright, yeah, let's cut it off, cut it here. I think that were two normal random battles where you might be able to learn something from, hopefully. Especially the newer players from you, of you, or someone who like to really improve their gameplay. And yeah, hope it helps out. Hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, see you next time. Bye bye.